I'm an introvert. I get most of my energy from spending more time by myself. But that doesn't mean that I'm antisocial or that I don't like talking. Hi everyone, it's Jamin here from Introverted and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I want to talk about why I started a YouTube channel as an introvert. In 2015, I had to do mandatory military service in South Korea for 2 years. And being in the military absolutely sucks, especially if you're an introverted person. In the South Korean army, you're in the boot camps with other soldiers for 24/7. So basically, you're forced to learn to become an extrovert as you are constantly socializing with people. In the beginning, I had a hard time adjusting to that groove. Over time, however, I became accustomed to that life. As I ranked up, I had to be responsible for the guys who were lower in rank, and I had to approach them and talk to them first. Not that I'm an extrovert now, but I definitely learned how to socialize with other people during that 2 years. Similarly, talking in front of the camera was definitely not my thing. When I first started making YouTube videos, I would waste anywhere from 5 to 10 minutes just on my intro. Every time I hit that record button on the camera, for some reason, I would just feel this pressure and I couldn't even say the most simple introduction. You have no idea how many times I had to repeat it and I felt so stupid. After making more than 20 videos on YouTube, however, I've become much more comfortable speaking in front of the camera. Hi everyone, it's Jamin and... except I still make mistakes. Now, here are some of the reasons why I started a YouTube channel. Number one, I get to talk about things that I'm interested in. Just because you're an introvert doesn't mean that you feel uncomfortable talking, especially talking about the things that you're interested in or you're passionate about. Since I love data science and I love sharing my experience and stories, I feel comfortable talking about it. Now, if I were to talk about, I don't know, like makeup or anything that I'm not familiar with, I probably would feel uncomfortable talking about it. Number two, I can practice storytelling skills. In the data world, or I guess in any field in general, you have to be able to communicate with your coworkers, your bosses, or business stakeholders, and storytelling skills play a huge role. Now, I'm not a very talkative person due to my introverted nature, but by sitting here and talking in front of the camera, I've been able to practice my public speaking skills. Number three, I can surround myself with like-minded individuals. Yes, I'm an introvert, but I love being able to connect with people who share the same interests as me. I'm just more selective when it comes to making friends or talking to people. This might not be a healthy thing, but I personally like to surround myself with positive people who I can learn from and who motivate me. And that's why I think doing YouTube is great, because I can connect with my viewers and other YouTubers and we get to exchange our knowledge. Number four, YouTube videos are the records of my work and they can potentially serve as my portfolio. If anyone found my videos helpful, I couldn't be happier. Plus, I can always go back and watch them at any time I want. They're kind of like the video versions of my diary. And last but not least, I can show what I do to my parents and family. I've been away from my family since 2017 and I haven't been able to visit them. With everything that's going on in the world right now, I probably won't be able to visit them anytime soon. I told my parents what data science is and what I'll be doing for a living, but it's quite difficult for me to make them fully understand what I do. Maybe it's just me, but explaining what data science is to my parents is one of the challenging things. If any one of you knows how to explain what data science is in a simple and straightforward way, please let me know in the comment section down below. But hopefully by producing more content on YouTube, they have a better understanding of what I do. So I shared a little bit of my introverted side and the reasons why I started my YouTube channel. If there's anything that's stopping you from making a YouTube channel, I would compare the ups and downs of starting a channel, and if the ups outweigh the downs, then as Nike says, just do it. To me, all I needed to get over was to being able to talk in front of the camera. I mean, I won't lie to you, it sucked in the beginning. And other than that, I learned how to handle criticism. Now, if you think that there are more downsides and you don't really want to start one, that's totally fine as well. There are many other ways to share your stories, and it doesn't necessarily have to be done through YouTube. And yeah, this is all I got for this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!